Hi, I'm Veena Gidwani, and today I'm going to share with you how to make a different kind of puri. It's tasty, it's easy to make, and Sindhis love it. We call it Masala Puri. You can have it for breakfast, or you could have it as an accompaniment with a meal. So keep watching. So let's take a look at the ingredients that go into making masala puri, or as we call it in Sindhi, kachori. I need 2 kachoris of wheat flour or gehu ka atta, 1/2 teaspoon of pepper or kali mirch powder, salt to taste, 1/2 teaspoon of jeera or cumin seed powder, 4 teaspoons oil for kneading the dough and oil for frying the puris, and water to make the dough. So let's start the process of making masala puris. I'm now first going to knead the dough, for which I need a large plate or a thal, as we call it. And I'm going to put the atta or the flour first into this. I'm keeping just a little bit of the flour for rolling out the puris. I'm now going to add the masalas or spices to the flour. So I'm first going to put 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper powder, 1/2 teaspoon of jeera powder, 4 teaspoons of oil, 1/2 teaspoon. I'm now going to mix all the spices and the oil well into the flour. The reason why we add oil to the flour is to give it the puri's crispness and softness at the same time. Now that all the spices are nicely blended into the flour, I'm going to knead the dough by adding water to it. I will keep adding water till the dough is nicely made. It still needs some more. You need to beat the dough well so that it's soft, the spices are all well blended, and you get nice crispy puris out of them. I'm just going to finish the dough making with just a touch of oil to give it the smoothness. The dough is now ready for us to roll out the puris, and to do that I'm going to put this little atta that I had kept here. And we'll now begin the process of making puris. And to do that, I'm first going to make small balls out of the dough. I'll make it into a ball and flatten it a bit. I'll flatten them. I'm going to now start rolling the puris. I dip each ball of the atta in the dry atta and then start the rolling process. While rolling, we should be careful that we do not put too much of the dry atta, because that will leave a residue on the puris and spoil the oil for you. Now that the puris have been rolled out and are ready, we are ready to fry them. So let's go and do that. So we are now ready to fry our puris, and I'm going to begin by putting the oil in the kadai. I'm going to light the flame now and allow the oil to get heated. I'm going to add a tiny speck of this puri to see if the oil is hot. The puri dot has come up immediately, which means the oil is hot and ready for me to fry the puris. So I'm now going to put in one puri at a time into the oil, gently drop it in, and I'm going to see that it's submerged in the oil, allow it to come up and swell up, then gently turn it over, and I have one side golden brown. And I'm going to do exactly the same on the other side. And now my puri is ready to be taken out of the oil. I drain out the excess oil and take it out on a tissue. Our masala puris are now ready. I have served them with aloo bhaji, but you could have them with dahi and papad as a breakfast dish, or you could have it as an accompaniment with a vegetable like bhi aloo badi or moong dal, both of which I have shared on India Food Network. So keep watching. And if you like our recipes, subscribe to India Food Network, and we'd love to have your feedback or comments.